Who's the James? You can't hide them.
Yeah, I will like a card on the table full of transparency. Armored Core is a franchise that I've always dabbled in, and I've made multiple entries in the series, but not the same way. I had like a I did have a fun with a couple of them here and there, but I wouldn't say I'm the biggest expert in Armored Core, so if I say anything that is like, I'm actually, I don't want to hear it. What I can say is, it was definitely interesting to see the changes they made to it. One that, there's kind of two groupings of changes, I feel like. One is the changes that they made for Armored Core fans in response to Armored Core, previous Armored Core games, and those are kind of, we'll get through some of that, but the other grouping of changes is the changes they've made to how Armored Core plays to make it closer to a From Software game. For transparency, or like, let's just get the elephant out of the room, is not a Souls-like. It does not play like a Souls-like in pretty much any measure that you would expect it to. It has some of the core principles of games in Souls-likes, but those aren't principles that are design principles, they are From Software principles. So the idea of challenge is core to the games that From Software makes them. And that is something that's very present in Armored Core. It has a similar kind of loop. So I guess from a design perspective, that's the closest you get to a From Software of Dark Souls-born loop. The idea of facing a challenge, dying, coming back and trying again. What it does is adapt it to make it work. One, for high-speed, fast-paced combat, and also two, kind of allow Armored Core fans to indulge kind of customizing cores and building the ideal mech for the scenario. So, going back a bit, the game isn't fast, it's not an open world in the way that any of the other games that they've made is. What they've gone for here is environments that are very open and dense, even detailed in terms of architecture and geometry. And the reason they do that is because they want you to really take advantage of the fact that Armored Cores can be quite nimble and move around in the environment. And it's not just when you're like engaged in one-on-one combat or any sort of combat. It's also an element of traversal. You fight a group of enemies. Some of them are simple stuff. You just use your standard like chain gun, machine gun, or shoulder cannon, and then you move on from this. Some of them are like bigger boss battles. But usually what you need to do is you fight one group, and then you kind of figure out how to find the next group and move to what's your main objective. And it's not like, go down this tunnel. It's like, go up, you know, through this hole, through these like kind of like girders in between this like smokestack, down through this like the kind of bridge, and along the way you're flying. The other part of it is like, the kind of like expansive enemies, and like, all groups of enemies, and also enemies that are quite different in how they play and fight. Them using the melee to take them out, so like you hit the button and it does the like side to side dash that everyone loves to see big robots do, and then there's like a blade that you use and take them out. When it came to like one of the core mini boss, like boss fights, it was way more of a ranged game. The core that we were shown was one that they had like pre-built and it was ready there, and the problem that one had was it was quite tanky, and so what happened was they fought another enemy that was quite hardy and also was very like damage output-y. So they got killed, then they went back to what is effectively the garage and showed us customization equipment, which were a lot. It was a lot of it. It's the kind of stuff that when you see it, you're like, oh, this is what the core part of the game is. This is like what the figure out how one thing works and how great it is, and that is where the loop kind of changes. Where it's like, instead of in Dark Souls, where you die to an enemy, you go back, try again. This is you die to an enemy, you go back, you look at the character that you have, what you have, and why did I die, what do I have to do, and you die.
Drake is just quite
go back and just get this game taken. You go on and then create that enemy and then move on. And then make your last part of the same thing happen. And it was maybe like 10 minutes later. It was like another major boss battle. Then they died straight away. And it was like, okay, the core I made for that previous boss no longer works here. So I need to go back into the garage and like figure this stuff out, change my core, upgrade things, and then okay. So it is that loop. But it's a loop that is catering towards Armored Core in a little more of a natural way. There's not much of a for that. There's a lot of story stuff that's kind of coming in and out, but I'm not super with the Armored story. But it's the Armored, I don't know the Armored Law, but you can have that one for free.
No, you can't. I said that.
Oscar, you're a licensed Armored Law for your videos. It feels like a game that Armored Core fans are going to enjoy to me, based on what I saw.
But do you think this will be the game that truly breaks through?
I don't think.
Why don't
I? Yes and no. I feel like if you are in the market for a kind of fun, smashy robot game, then you can pick that up, and it looks like it'll be very playable. And it feels like it looked like you could get through it without, like, really hitting major walls in that you would in a Souls game, provided you engage with the various people. The people who love Armored Core, they're going to see this stuff, and once they get their hands on it, I think they're going to enjoy what they have, whether it's add more variety to things that Armored Core is capable of making, and they don't want to be pigeonholed as they can do that when you make Souls games. They want to move away from that, they want to give themselves like safety net, diversity in the catalog, and longevity, and the way you do that is explore different kinds of games. And I think this is going to be a good step towards doing that. It kind of reminds me of Ace Combat Soul Price, which is another brand new game in the Ace Combat series, very niche series, but the Soul Price came out, people were like, this is really good. It was basically like Ace Combat.
And then, stepping stone.
Yeah, the stepping stone to a new kind of like hero world. Ace Combat. It's got like a new hero. And it's just good to see Ace Combat. So they kept alive for many, many generations on a very unique community.